And ENT, the real name for our specialty is otolaryngology, but because that's so difficult to say or to remember, people just say ENT, meaning ear, nose, and throat doctor. And otolaryngology is just Latin for ENT. So many people think that we're just physicians, medical doctors, but we're actually a subspecialty of surgery. And we treat everything from tonsils to sinus disease to head and neck cancer. Yeah, there are many ways that the field of ear, nose, and throat medicine is advancing. First of all, in treating hearing disorders and treating hearing loss, there are many implantable devices for treating hearing loss that we didn't have 10, 15 years ago, and the technology is just growing. There's also more and more in-office procedures to treat ear, nose, and throat diseases that previously were only offered in surgery or weren't offered at all. There are two main categories of hearing loss. One is from chronic ear infections, and one is just run-of-the-mill hearing loss, whether it be from noise exposure or something you get passed on from your family genetics. So chronic ear infections often will require surgery on the middle ear and to repair the eardrum and the middle ear structures. However, there are now new surgical procedures to treat hearing loss. The three main surgeries are, one, cochlear implants, and currently those are approved for adults and children who have profound hearing loss and that do not benefit from hearing aids. Number two, there are totally implantable hearing aids now that are approved for patients who are not benefiting from hearing aids but are not quite candidates for cochlear implants. And that's a hearing aid that's surgically implanted into the ear with no external device. The third option is the Baha. It's a device that is approved for three reasons. Number one, for patients with a conductive hearing loss, meaning the inner ear and nerve of hearing is normal, but the sound is not getting conducted into the inner ear. Number two, for a mixed loss, where they have hearing loss both at the level of the nerve and a conductive loss. And number three, for patients with single-sided deafness, where they have completely normal hearing on one side but are completely deaf on the opposite side. The Baha is a device that is a titanium implant that is placed behind the ear. So it's not actually a surgery on the ear, but it's a surgery on the skull. And then once the patient is healed from the surgery, the hearing aid snaps onto that titanium device and it vibrates the bone, and that vibration carries sound into the inner ear. And in patients with single-sided deafness, the Baha will vibrate the bone and it will carry the sound to the good ear, and so they can get sound localization, getting sound from the microphone on that side of the head and also from their good ear. So it improves their ability to localize sound and improves their hearing and background noise. When I see a patient and I think they are a candidate for a Baha, I will refer them to the audiologist and they'll do an evaluation, including fitting the patient with a Baha and seeing how it will sound. So they do a demonstration for the patient and the patient can know instantly whether they'll benefit from that technology.
For more information about this physician or to schedule an appointment, please call our referral line or visit notbiggerjustbetterhealth.com.